Girls going, the hour of the bells. From now on, a feather in my hat. To live in fire, the Grand Hotel. Free music in a circle. Into the air, the local. Nonsense, it's only like pearls on down. Reading the sun. Evening, restless. Gardens, gaslights. Into the barroom, boys. Nothing happening. Girls going. The pavement, collars hanging. Hotel. Summer. Organ grinder into a country road. The tramp in black, all belly, laid a brick down on the sidewalk at Broadway and Ann Street, one by Astor House, one catty corner, one outside St. Paul's, and one last he swapped for the one at the crossroad, for the one up the block, for the one catty corner, for the one by the church. No words, repeat. And on the hour, the bells clanging, he walked with a mob after, into the tolerable dark wood halls, wide stairs, freaks and phenomenons of the new museum, till a blue cop made me stop blocking the sidewalk with the mystery, and I paid the tramp off. He'd only come in to bum a nickel. Museum or no, Mr. Barnum, there's St. Paul's poplars, and you can't, it's sacrilegious for you to tie your flags to them. Are you English or what? Haul down Old Glory on the 4th of July? Hey, Deacon, I'd like to see you dare. Look, Islander, Barnum is right. You want to save your bones, you better slope. All right, I'm going. Yeah, and you, from now on, clergy pays full in the American Museum. Ah, late. Bless it. After the fireworks were touched off and the smoke blown, the sidelong stars all down and the fourth over, is when I made my entrance. Back in 1810, the year, I don't know what, in Bethel, Fairfield County, Connecticut. That name is Indian for the River of Pines, my cradle. I was fattened on holy pokes and maple sap in the country of the Wappernocker. Oh, the Wyndham bullfrogs and the Moodus noises, where the humility bird can see the spark and outfly a gunshot, and the dew mink sings. And Mrs. Fitch of Norwalk stuck a feather in her brother's cap, and he was Yankee Doodle. Hey, Barnum, what piss in the ocean price for this here jackknife? 4 bits. Horseshit, it ain't worth half. Well, excuse me, sir, but I'm afraid it's my duty to fine you $1 for cursing. Ha! I'm a Knickerbocker, and I don't give a turd for your Connecticut blue laws. That'll be $2. Excuse me, sir, but who the hell are you? I'm Seely, Justice of the Peace. $3. You're kidding. Oh, my Jesus, what an asshole. Oh, shit, I swore again. My hat! What's that, a quarter? Holy gee, what am I doing in this jerk-off town? Get fined by a little bastard. I'll piss on you! I'm obstropolous, son of a bitch. I don't believe you, goddamn yahoos. $11. What? Oh, for crap's sake. I'm about to blow my top and swear, you blue skin, limp dick, ass kissing. What am I up to? $15. Here's 20, old fart. And keep the chain. I think I'll be cursing it off damn quick. I had old Lyman walk on in a false beard. Ladies and businessmen, boys and playgirls, hello, salam, and welcome to the Opera House. I am Dr. J. Griffin of Pernambuco, agent for a museum of natural, I don't know what, in the old country, and I'm here on Broadway to exhibit, not for gain, but your gratification, items bagged in the blank regions of the terrestrial globe, all specimens which are double in anatomy, the missing links in the chain of species. Ah, look on in wonder at the mud iguana from the mountains of the moon, the platypus, half seal, half duck, I captured down under among the Aborigines in a long battle. The salamander, able to live in fire, caught in a blue grotto, and the paddle-tail snake I inveigled from the Hokey Pokey tribe along the King of Rivers at a considerable risk. Oh, and the flying fish from the Gulf Stream. And last, the star of the bizarre collection, taken in the nets of a heathen Chinese fisherman in the southern seas and worshipped as a god in the celestial empire. Gee willikers, it's ugly. The only mermaid. We saw Vivala, the professor of equilibrium and plate dancing, paralyzed on the left with a smart dog that ran a spinning wheel. We gossiped about old tours and gave him $500 and a ticket home. She sang to him. He died in the Herald later, thanking us. Sir, I don't mind you hissing, Signor Vivala. That's all behind us. I'm glad you answered the $1,000 challenge. It was to you. Now, the point is, you lose if you don't match all his tricks, like it says in the newspaper. You can spin plates, but 10 at once, or balance a broomstick on the tip of your nose. Can you stilt walk and aim and shoot a musket? You can toss balls, but he's a hocus pocus. It's not a Yankee trick. You read the ad. Don't get your back up. I can be a friend. Green Circus is closed now, right? You can lose a grand or make $30 a night. Go on stage versus Vivala. Make it look real, play beat, then challenge him to juggle next night. Is it a deal? Sign right here. And our receipts jumped through the roof. First evening. Restless. No reason. I walked from the gardens. Gaslights like pearls on down. Into the barroom, wise-ass boys. Full of cocktails, nothing happening. Girls going by, loud wheels on the pavement, tall flagpole, colors hanging, and past the Grand Hotel, summer. The poor organ grinder with his monkey outwear. Country road. Four stories, and at the tip-top, calcium lights showered Broadway. Ice cream was served up in the aerial garden. The stars and stripes, banners flying by the mystery windows, images of all birds and beasts in creation. Balcony with free music and out of tune brass band doing bad marches to drive the citizens of the city of fools inside. And I'd skyrocket the American Museum. Open at sunrise. Admittance one quarter, children half price. Under this roof you'll see arithmetic horses, educated dogs, trained fleas, wild cranes, flamingos, anacondas, yaks, camelopards, white tigers, old baboons, gypsies, dwarfs, albinos, giants, fat boys, American Indians in battle and prayer, dissolving views, dioramas of the creation and the flood, storms, waterfalls, models of cities, live statues, minstrels, rope dancers, jugglers, marionettes, pantomimes, ventriloquists, fortune tellers, and Yankees. Glass blowing, mechanical looms, photography, etc. and an advertising curtain on a new scale. She was a pygmy growing out of a salmon, sea demon in rigor, in agony, her skin all black, wrinkled, one frail hand up to her cheek and one curled on her flat paps, lips in a circle baring her awful teeth, scales down her hairs and a frayed tail twisting back along her. The woolly horse was foaled in Indiana. It was a cross between a camel for hair, deer legs, elephant tail, and jumped 12 feet into the air. The papers said Colonel Fremont, missing so long, lost in Rocky Mountain snows, was found. I said he'd captured it. Senator Benton sued me for false pretenses, arguing the animal was nowhere in the explorer's letters, and the judge threw it out. I let it loose in my acres. Folks riding the local saw the woolly horse out eating Barnum's grass. At last, I went on stage. The nightingale has told me in secret tonight's gate goes to the fire department, musical fund society, poor women home, colored orphan asylum, and the Underground Railroad, all because, she says, the tickets are too expensive. She's blessed America. Their hearts, their wallets. The songbird, scared and pious, the divine Jenny, for sale, 10 cents. Oh, bonnets, shawls, gloves, robes, chairs, couches, pianos, cards, whiskies, horses, rags, and polkas. I can't seem to say why I tried All Hollow 3 months like a jackass to keep the Crystal Palace World's Fair from crashing, like building a railroad to the moon. 1,500 players doing the Messiah and the crowd of 40,000 drowning it out, mock fire of fireworks outside the dome, the choir hooting hey day at the firemen, the orchestra squalling the monster concert. With a bad location, bad management, it was dead, not to be raised. Move it to Boston Common as a convention center. What are you saying, Barnum? I sloughed it off and I made ought. It burned. Fire's warning. Why in tarnation that flag? Calm down, Lyman, you old sixpence. Everyone on Broadway knows where to catch the mermaid. Well, I have to do the pitch, and it gets tight with a flag 6 yards long for a monster that's one. Nonsense. It's only to draw them in, and they know it. It costs $70. Barnum, maybe you can fight under that flag, not me. You win, it's down. First evening, restless, no reason. I walked from the Battery Gardens on the sidewalk, gaslights like pearls on down. Dog barking, last block of ice into the barroom, wise ass boys in their turned down collars, full of cocktails, nothing happening. Girls going by in blue silk ribbons, a pair of horses, hack cab, loud wheels on the pavement by the market, pineapples, tall flagpole and the colors hanging, past the Grand Hotel, the bowling alley, the oyster cellar, the lecture room, summer, and a poor organ grinder with his monkey out where country road. I'm in the ticket office reading the Sun. This buck in old sailor's clothes loitering and a whaling narrative in his back pocket. One, please. All right, sir. Is Mr. Barnum in the museum? That's him. That's him. It's me. That's it. I got my money's worth. He threw his ticket away.